Octopus? Possibly not. Spaceship? Probably yes. Now the next one is not a particularly old detector. This is a late 90s, I think. But I'm just showing you this one because this was the kind of like the first generation of the reliable detectors. Now, it was known that if you ever had a problem with a conventional PIR, this was the one to fit. This one would reduce your false alarms. Well, reduce your false alarms? You don't really want to reduce them, you want to stamp them out. But this was the detector that would do it. Had a little bit more technology inside it, and it did the job. Pretty good detector, this one. So let's have a look at the lens pattern, and as you can see, it's sealed, so no spiders can get inside there. This isn't the plastic lens on the front, this is the plastic mirror behind, which gives a better definition of the area that it's looking at, because it can't bend like a plastic lens can. So we've got the pyroelectric detector up there, and that then reflects in the lens here, and if I go really close, you should be able to see it. There it is. Oh, yeah. Oh, look. It's a bit like a spider's eye, isn't it? As you take it back, you can see where it's looking out. And you've got a big one at the side there, big zone, and that's to counteract the angle that pyroelectric detector has to look. I mean, if it's looking directly ahead, it can see quite easily. But when you're stretching that to look that way, you know, it's not like, if you can imagine that's the pyroelectric detector. When it's forced to look sideways like that, it then becomes not as effective, and you can't really see much of a surface area. So to compensate for that, they've made these lenses slightly bigger on the sides. So we've got the look down zones, which are, there's quite a lot of them actually. So you've got the main zones here that look across the room, then these ones start looking downwards, so we've got quite a few zones across there. And then if you want to look right down, wow, those ones up there. A few clips on this to get it back to normal, but I'm just going to leave it on there. Now, I was trying to look for the model number of this, and I saw that it was an IR220. But then, yes, another thing is this is 1998. And I thought, well, I probably got this from Blue Circle, so they probably put the batch sticker over the top, and I was right. It's an Alarmcom detector. Now, that LED there is orange and it lights up red. Now this makes me think of a PIR that we looked at before, which was this one here. How the hell do you open this when it's mounted up on a wall? But there you go, there's the same LED. So it makes me think that the company that used to make these was Arrowhead. And I do remember these from a while ago, and the name Arrowhead seems to tie in with this particular detector, but maybe they were bought out by Alarmcom. Can't get that cover on now. And this is not as sensitive as the other detectors. I mean, it's in my hand, I'm right next to it, I'm moving around in front of it, and it's not picking me up as much as what the other ones were. So, as I said before, there's a little bit more intelligence than these. It didn't go straight into alarm when it saw something. It kind of like thought about it and just verified that it was definitely motion that it saw. Anyway, there you go, that's the Alarmcom IR220. Very good, reliable detector, that one.